Sunday was the last day of the Slovak leg of the 2015 Winter Universiade. Russia looking to add to their double-digit gold medal tally in Strbske Pleso. Fans eagerly awaiting the men's 30 kilometres mass start. The final event was a men's team competition in ski jumping. Under sunny skies, Japan and Poland challenging Russia for medals.
Well, we're at Strbske Pleso for the final cross-country skiing event. The weather is absolutely fabulous. Clear skies. They can see the tips of the mountains at last. It's absolutely gorgeous. The conditions should suit a reasonably quick time. We didn't get a lot of snow overnight, so there's no extra powder to worry ourselves about. It's the 30-kilometer mass start, the marathon, the prize, the big prize. And it looks the favourites. When you look at the start list, it's got Russia written all over it. They've won the all three medals in each of the other two individual events for the men's, the sprint and the 10K. And they're odds-on favourites to do it again. They have the five fastest ranked skiers in the start. That man wearing number one, Andray Larkov, he won the sprints. But also in the Russian group, you've got Raul Shakirzianov wearing two. Andrey Feller, the gold medalist in the 10 kilometer, he's wearing number three. Artem Nikolaev has four on his chest. Ravil Valiakhmetov wearing number five. Others to look out for, Alexis Jeannereau of France, he wears seven. Ivan Arojo wearing eight. Yevgeny Velichko has nine. And Takatsugu Uda wearing 10. He's the main Japanese hope following the withdrawal of Hiroyuki Miyazawa. Alexis Jeannereau of France working extremely hard at the front of the leading group alongside Jakob Graf wearing 13, the Austrian from the Technical University of Liberec. These two setting the pace a little bit for the opening group, doing the hard work. The question really whether they could sustain it right until the end. The final bell, or the bell for the final lap going, and it's still Jeannereau in front. And Graf working hard as well. But the Russians, the other Russians, you can see Larkov number one and Shakirzianov number two settle quite happily in the middle of that pack along with the Japanese Uda. Nikolaev working hard with Larkov. And then heading into the last lap. This was the break. This was a big break from Uda, the Japanese, looking to break that leading pack wide apart, really scorching up the snow on this uphill, really nasty uphill. But he took Larkov with him, the big Russian, not letting him get away. And that, in the end, was to prove key because Uda couldn't keep it up. Nikolaev, and with him, the Ravil Valiakhmetov, Larkov, and Shakirzianov, they swept past him. Nikolaev wearing four. Larkov wearing one. It's Larkov, the sprint champion, who cornered quickest and was into the final straight. He was being chased by Shakirzianov. It was down to these two, Larkov and Shakirzianov. Larkov working the poles hard, in the final sprint. Shakirzianov perhaps leaving himself just a little bit too much to do. Larkov burning away from his teammates, coming over the line to take the gold medal. Shakirzianov took third, and it was Artem Nikolaev who stretched furthest. He had just a yard ahead of Ravil Valiakhmetov. So Nikolaev took the bronze medal. It's another clean sweep for the Russians. Indeed, look at that. The top five positions, six in the top ten. They've taken the honours throughout this cross-country skiing competition, particularly in the men, where they've taken all nine medals available in the individual events, and they also won the relay. There it is. Andray Larkov wins gold. Raul Shakirzianov takes the silver. Artem Nikolaev takes the bronze.
Welcome to the last event of the Slovak leg of these Universiade, and it's the fifth ski jumping event, and it's the only one really so far not dominated by Russia. And today we have 10 teams going in this men's competition. Norway, Czech Republic, Ukraine, Germany, Finland, Slovenia, Japan, Austria, Russia and Poland. Russia, the big favourites, with Hazedinov looking for a second medal. But look out for Japan too, with Junichiro Kobayashi looking for a second gold. He got a mixed team gold. Stop. To Takanashi, looking to give Japan a good start, and that's just over the 90 metres. That's a good jump from the Japanese. Minato Mabuchi. To 87 and 88.5 metres in the individual. Can he go towards 90? It was just short. It's a good effort, though. Probably just a metre or two short of 90. There's the third Japanese jumper going. I'm sure Kobayashi's had a really good tournament, and he's continuing it there. So the favourites are Russia. Is Klimov. How far can he go? He's got a lot of potential, and that's a monster jump from Evgeny Klimov. Well, that's at least 96 metres. Mikhail Maksimoshkin, disappointed that he didn't do better in the individual. Multiple Universiade medalist, looking for 90, and I think he's just about got 90 there. Keeps Russia in a good position. Inmir Hazetinov. Such a great potential. Olympic Games competitor, and that was pretty good as well. Coached by Ramel Abramov. Poland, now they're the defending champions in this competition, 2 years ago winning gold. Andrzej Zebatosny for Poland. Yeah, he's made his 90 quite comfortably. That's a good jump from him. Jakub Kot. He's going down as the best Polish jumper today. Jakub Kot came 15th in the individual. Two jumps, just a little bit under 90. It's considerably short though, 85 metres. Well, let's see what that means after the first half of this competition, after the third round. Russia are leading. But, you know, the gap is only 5.1 points. So there are a lot of work to do. Poland 24.4 behind the leaders, and Germany in with a shout as well. Florian Menz going for Germany. They'd need to do something really special to get a bronze. Certainly at least look to get fourth. And, yeah, that's a good jump from Menz, you know. It's a little bit short of 90. Kanta Takanashi. Second half of the competition getting underway. Japan looking to chase Russia down and perhaps get the gold. Evgeny Klimov, a superb jump, 96.5 metres, and looking to do better. That's a big ask, but he's going and going. That's a brilliant jump. Klimov has got, that's nearly 100 metres, 98 metres. And there's Andrey Zabochny, 95 metres for him. 5th of 6 jumpers, Jan Mailander. Germany really just looking to defend their 4th place for the moment. Is that Minato Mabushi needs something special, needs to go well over 90 if they've got any chance of getting a gold. Well, it's decent, but I don't think it'll be enough. Mikhail Maksimoshkin. The Russians just need to be sensible now. Some solid jumps over the 90 and the gold should be theirs. That's exactly what Maksimoshkin's done. Stanislav Biela going for Poland. Maybe they can catch the Japanese. If there's going to be a change in the top three, that'll be it. Bielak needs well over 90. 93.5. Tobias Seaman. Germany now, no chance realistically of getting a medal. Should be good enough for fourth though. Junshiro Kobayashi, he needs a huge jump really. And well, that's very impressive. Probably won't be enough to get a gold. Cot, it's around the 90. And that's going to be enough for Russia. Ilmir Hazedinov is coming now. Jakub Kot then, well, that jump, not quite enough. And Russia have quite comfortably won the gold by 20.9 points. Japan have to be content with the silver, with Poland getting the bronze, 42.9 behind Russia. It's a third gold medal in the ski jumping for the Russians.
Thank you. Education meets sport and culture. What best promotes excellence in mind and body? Where do friendship, integrity, and achievement meet? Which event gathers the best student athletes from around the world? The Universiade, the home of international university sports. Today's stars, tomorrow's leaders.